undefeated Miami. And here we go, Kermit. Mario Pender out. That's a big Berrios is actually fairly big for Miami. Let's get on with it. Hello, boys and girls. My name is Flipper55 with Fat Finger Gaming, and this is Fat Finger Gaming's continuing coverage of the 2015 college football season. Today, conference championships, ACC championship, undefeated Miami versus 9-3 Florida State. These two met in Tallahassee week six. It was a 34-17 win. Miami obviously is win Miami because they are undefeated. Miami wins this. Miami will be going to the playoffs. All right, as Florida State takes the field in week six, as I said, in Tallahassee, these two met. And it would be Miami walking away with a 34-17 win over Florida State. Now, here's the thing. There were no turnovers. Now, let me clue you in on this. Miami right now is second in the nation as far as turnover differential. At 15, obviously they lead the ACC. Florida State minus 3 overall. So you would think that this game would come down to just Miami getting a bunch of turnovers. And if it does, this is going to be a blowout. Why? Because in that week 6 meeting in Tallahassee, no turnovers. All it was Miami just being the better team. They had over 100 yards total offense. They had a better third down conversion. They had more time possession. I mean, it's just they controlled, and a lot of it had to do with Gus Edwards. They controlled a lot. Florida State always seemed to be down by at least 7 the whole way through the game. Oh, Delvin Cook. Now, this is where Mario Pender would have come in handy there, as he is out for the game. So really, it is going to come down. I think the ACC championship will come down to turnovers only a little differently than you might think. That's Ermin Lane right there for Florida State. Getting that first down. Getting down inside the 35-yard line. So, as I was saying, it's going to come down to turnovers, but not the way you'd think it'd come down to. Florida State must, I believe Florida State must create turnovers, and they must not turn over the ball. Simple as that. If this thing does the same thing as it did down in Tallahassee, in which neither team turns over the ball, they will lose. You got Antoine Crawford back in Miami. He is tied for second with 7 interceptions overall. He's tied for second in the nation with 7 interceptions overall. So there are definitely turnover machines on there. And look at that. Another catch by Ermin Lane. Golson Lane hooking up here. Doing a good job here early, moving the ball against Miami. Cook breaking some tackles. So it's going to be 2nd-4 down inside the 10-yard line. And already this current drive. Florida State doing a good job moving the ball here. Will it end in a touchdown? That's the important thing, getting a touchdown. There's a throw into the end zone. That's Ermin Lane, touchdown Florida State. They go up 7-0. By the way, the Fat Finger point spread on this game, I believe, half. Yeah, it's 9.5. Don't worry about that Temple Navy game. We are definitely going to play it out in Navy last week. And for Temple, their winning streak reaches 5. This one's going to be down. Navy last week beat Army to finish up the regular season undefeated. With that win, I decided that we will definitely next week, that'd be our Wednesday night Twitch, 8:45. I will start off with the American Conference game. And there's Gus Edwards at Florida State wrapping him up easily. He'll obviously be the key to this, and now they're going to go without Gus Edwards and go to empty. Oh, no, I guess Gus Edwards, yeah. That's not a way to get Gus Edwards the ball. Get a fullback in front of him. And that
one's incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Wilson. Three and out for Miami. Undefeated Miami, folks.
He's to the 40. Brought down at the 47-yard line.
I was really impressed with their last series. They came out with a focus on the passing game, and the offense got the job done. We'll see if they have the same.
All right. Can Florida State continue the pressure here against the Hurricanes?
Steps out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
Now, what's going on here is Oklahoma is one of the bigger fans of Florida State right now. Florida State win. Florida State will not make the college football playoff. So, therefore, if Florida State. So if Florida State wins, that leaves one spot wide open, a spot that we thought was going to Miami, and that spot obviously looks pretty good for Oklahoma to fill in. We are not going to ship a 12-1 Miami team that just lost the championship or a 11-1 Virginia Tech team that only lost to Miami. That kind of thing's not happening. We don't do that around here. Here you have to win a conference in order to get into the college football playoffs. Just real interesting about Navy. If Navy goes undefeated, another little dish to Urban Lane, and he is Golson's favorite receiver, but I tell you, we have not seen a game like this out of him so far this season. Doing a great job here off the start, and you know, we're not even at the end of the first quarter.
And they make the stop around the 17-yard line.
Third and six. The U needs to get some of that swag. Make this stop. Herman Lane at the bottom of your screen, so you know they're going to be looking for him, and they just sort of were looking for him, I guess. I don't know what that was. First incompletion of the game for Everett Golson.
They'll line it up for the field goal. Florida State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. The kick is up, and it sails through the upright.
And there it is. 10-0 Florida State already.
The kicker looks like he's
so Miami, who had complete control down in Tallahassee, you move the game up to Charlotte, and they've come out just a little bit flat. In fact, I can't think of a game we've done which Miami's come out flat. They mostly have just had to hold on to the lead. The only thing they've been able to do, the only bad part about them is normally in the second half they start losing a lead or they'll lose the lead, as the case with UNC. Gus Edwards can't get going, but he does get 5 yards. He's going to be the man that's got to get going, and normally he is already operating as they come out of the tunnel. I forget who's in motion, but that is Kaya's favorite guy, and he breaks the tackle but still gets sacked. Third and seven. So Miami in danger of having two straight three and outs to start this game. Undefeated number two Miami, folks. Breaks the tackle and just it does a good job just getting that away without getting a sack. However,
they defended the play very well in the secondary.
The defense has everybody on the
line. That's still three and out, folks.
And this one is a beauty. He's got the corner.
So Florida State takes over on the 38.
Just a nice rhythm.
Been doing a beautiful job moving the ball.
Balanced attack, running and throwing, and right now this defense just can't stop him.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up.
Fake handoff, Golson. I don't know who he's going for there. All right, so we're going to start getting some incompletions here from Golson. Maybe he's going to start looking mortal. He has come out looking beautiful. Finally, a little bit of life here. Third and 13.
All day,
Can Miami get their first stop of the game? Going to set up a little screen pass to Delvin Cook. Delvin Cook has got some blockers, but his blocker cannot pick up that man right there, and he gets him before he can get started. Fourth and 11, they're going to have to punt the ball.
Tries to get around the corner. Tackle made at the 35. The Seminoles are smothering.
All right, so speaking of the ACC, we're going to talk about the ACC here for a second. In real life, the ACC, and also, for that matter, talk about the SEC just setting this up. Since our resident Auburn fan is here.
There was good pressure coming in, but
he
stood his ground and found his team.
We will
a nice game.
Just, not really, I'm not going to poke fun at him. I'm just going to say, last week he was saying there's Georgia, there's no way Alabama's going to win. Now, the reason why I bring this up is because of the ACC and because of Clemson. And there's Kaya's, Jake O'Donnell, he's his favorite receiver there. Anyways, so
this quarterback likes throwing the ball to this kid?
I give him a pass. I will give him a pass for saying that there's no way Alabama will win. I basically said there's no way Alabama won't win. I still see them as the Crimson Machine, and Georgia was going to try to do to Alabama basically what Alabama tries to do to everyone. I didn't see that working. Did not see it working, obviously, in the game. Alabama just drilled them. Now, the reason why I bring this up is to give our resident Auburn fan a pass at that, because when you have blind hatred towards a team, you cannot make a third-party decision on how good or bad that team is. It's very hard. Some people can do it. Most people can't detach themselves enough.
First down, 10 to go.
However, well, to add to that point, now getting back to the ACC, Clemson, Notre Dame. I didn't think there was any way on this green earth that Clemson could beat Notre Dame. I'm not saying Notre Dame is that great. I think they're a solid overall team. Not saying they're a great team. Trust me. I'm saying they're a top 25 team, and that's about it. Thought there was no way that Clemson... I didn't even think Clemson was going to be in the game because of just how bad the ACC's been. And for that matter, I didn't see anything out of Clemson. Now, I'm an NC State fan. There's where that blind hatred comes in. Evidently, I'm missing something in Clemson. Evidently, I'm not seeing something that a lot of other people have been seeing. That they said was this game was going to be a game. And I was wrong. It happens. As I said, sometimes you can detach yourself and make that call. Sometimes you can't. I obviously cannot make that detached call about Clemson. And I am shocked that they actually beat Notre Dame. I'm shocked that they're number six. Seriously, I don't understand how they're... Oh, my God, that almost was a pick going back the other way. Kaya, 2 for 5. Third goal on the 5. They need this. God, do they... Well, you know, I guess field goal will bring them within 7, so that's all right. There's a throw into the end zone. That's Jake O'Donnell, but he's going to be short. He's coming out of the end zone as he caught that. Now, the question is, field goal? Yeah, they're going to go for your field goal.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. He gets it up, and they...
Now, looking forward to this college football week, I will go ahead and say right now that I believe that six unranked teams will be ranked teams this week.
He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 28.
I'm not going to say guaranteed, but that's what I believe. I believe this week, and I don't know what the record is of unranked teams beating ranked teams, but I don't know. I got a feeling. Just got a feeling. I was shocked that Florida handled Ole Miss. I was shocked because I didn't think Florida had anything. I thought Ole Miss was a fairly good team. I thought Florida was just the mess that Florida has been. So I got to give Florida great props for that. Maybe they are. Maybe they are something. Maybe they will contend for the East. Maybe they will have the. Maybe they will be the East team that loses this year to the SEC West. Who knows? Lord knows you got to pass that around a little bit. I mean, you got six straight losses for the SEC East. So we will see if it makes it seven. And I think he was down. There's that turnover. Now, that's what I've been saying. Florida State needs that turnover to go the other way. And they're not that he was not down. I am going to actually take a quick look at this one. Because I was under the impression he was down. He obviously wasn't. Here comes the hit. Oh, there it is. Knee off the ground. There it is. Big turnover there, and that's Florida State, I was saying, needed to create turnovers to win this because I thought a turnover-less game actually fell right in Miami's hands. Now, obviously, going up 10-0, a turnover-less game does not automatically lead to a Miami win as I was thinking that it would.
There was some movement on the line.
And they just keep going back. Still second down. Tell you what, one of the things that hurts is a turnover turning into a punt. You know, basically when all it does is change field position, it hurts. To me, that hurts. Oh, there's Gus Edwards. He broke one tackle. Had he been able to get through the hole quicker, that would have been a very long gainer. And he is the man that Miami needs to get going here. And unfortunately, they get 3rd and 10, so they set up in a situation which Gus Edwards won't help you too much. Kaya going deep. He's got his man. 3rd and 10, and he throws a 52-yard bomb. And we are tied here in the ACC championship. Oh, man. That is why the U is undefeated, boys and girls. This is my favorite team to hate. And they are starting, they're starting to get good enough. They're looking like that good old favorite team to hate.
He sends this one deep. Miami, to kick this one off. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And for Bush, he's having himself a pretty good game.
This is one of those guys that just flat out.
So 4:11 left to go to half, and that's got to hurt. Turnover followed by a bomb, and now it's all tied up.
But he still has made so many plays. And at some point, this offense is going to have to start to make some adjustments because this guy's all over the field.
Swear to God, I thought I switched Golson's number to 6. Obviously, I did not.
Do to slow him down and give yourself a chance.
He's been 5 throughout the season. Throughout Fat Finger season, because I didn't know he was going to switch his number to 6. But we'll just keep it at 5. Good old memories of Jameis Winston, the best quarterback the Florida State's ever had. Oh, Golson fits it in there to Jesus. Wilson.
His best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 50-yard line.
We got the Earthshaker on Twitch already calling the game.
Catches it and he's looking for more.
Doesn't believe that Florida State can rebound from a from that type of dagger. Now, Earthshaker's calling. Miami should win. That is a reason why the fat finger flipping point spread is 9.5 for Miami. If the point spread was 9.5, where would you go? What would you do? Would you say Miami or would you say Florida State? Oh, look at that. Golson breaks a tackle. And obviously, this far into the halftime, it really. obviously you gotta go with the points now, I would think.
He's gonna try and scramble.
Oh, Golston's gonna get down to the 5-yard line, so it looks like Florida State getting back. Look at like Florida State might actually take the lead back.
First down. They've got four cracks at it inside the five. It's first and goal.
It's the reason why it is hard to win. It's hard to get the lead back when you're down two scores. Because even after you get back those two scores, and Cook just cannot get in. 2 minutes left to go in the half.
This linebacker's had a couple years of experience, and he's really solidified himself as a reliable tackler, as you can see from that last stop.
They're crowding the line.
Earthshaker wants to talk about the Alabama-Georgia game some more. Seriously, what do you want to talk about? It was... it was domination. It was what Alabama normally does. I mean, that is the Crimson Machine.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Hurricanes really had it going early, and things were going their way. And now it's a drought here in quarter number two.
Well, I think the defense that they're facing has done a much better job of playing with more intensity and making it tougher on them. It's going to be an interesting battle throughout the entire game to see who gets the upper hand.
Here we go. 395.
With room to work.
I like it. They're not afraid
to try. All right, minute 53. Let's see if Miami can get down here and tie this ball game up. Now Miami will get the ball to start off the second half. So
they picked up the first down. I wouldn't be surprised.
Definitely not.
First and 10.
Definitely not out of it. Nice little throw to there. I guess Berrios was probable. I thought he was gone. It was just flat out the Georgia Alabama game was just complete domination. You had quarterbacks dropping the ball. Wow, he's looking for Cooley again. Just could not get him.
They know to get their hands up in the air and to try to knock down passes.
From the 46-yard line, second down.
Yeah, it is. Anytime you see vulnerability, you'll get people. I feel like they're trying to drum up the drama. Like, you know, when they see vulnerability in Alabama, all of a sudden, oh, Georgia's going to beat them. My favorite team, Buffalo Bills. And all I had to hear before the New England game was how Buffalo, you know, this is Buffalo's year. This is how they're going to do it. Yada, yada, yada. You know, oh, my God, and it got picked off. So Kaya gets an interception. 1:16 left to go is going to be on the 43-yard line. So Florida State's going to be set up fairly nice. So all I heard before the game was all these analysts telling me how Buffalo's going to win, how Buffalo's going to win, how Buffalo's going to win. Me as a fan, me as a fan of Buffalo, you would think that I would buy into it. But I know Buffalo. I know what talent is on Buffalo right now. I know I've seen Buffalo when they are one of the best in the NFL. So I know what Buffalo looks like when they're one of the best in the NFL. And that's what you have to be to beat New England. And of course, New England just completely stomps on them. Now Buffalo was able to bring it back to within 8 towards the end of the game, but still, it was a good whooping. It wasn't as bad a whooping as Georgia. I mean, Georgia didn't even come close to making a game at the end. I mean, I think, what was it? Was it midway or late in the third quarter? People were leaving the stadium down in between the hedges. They were sort of like slinking out in between the hedges looking for the tunnels. Which is bad. Which is really, really, really bad. And look at this. Touchdown, Florida State. And we may have our first upset in these conference games. Next up will be Auburn versus Georgia. Speaking of Georgia,
the Pac-12 championship game. This is a game we've been watching closely today. And for USC, they are asserting their will.
This one's going to be down in the end.
Yeah, we'll see how the Pac-12 does Wednesday. That will be the Pac-12 championship. We're going to go. Our Wednesday Twitch will be, we'll start off 8:45. Kickoff will be Navy versus Temple in the American Conference, just because Navy is undefeated. We're going to show them for the hell of it. Then it will be, we'll move on to the Big Ten, which I think will be the best game of the conference championships. It's going to be Wisconsin versus Michigan State. Then we'll move on to Oregon, USC. Speaking of Oregon, USC, or speaking of Oregon at least. So Oregon gets crushed by Utah a couple weeks ago. But a couple days ago, they did something that's extremely telling to me. Oregon, and I didn't watch the game, so I don't know. Oregon, Colorado. Only won 41-24. I mean, this is a Colorado team, which people laughed at as a team that shouldn't be in any kind of Division I play. They've had a lot of losses. Not a lot. I think for three straight years, they have lost to somebody not in the FCS. So to me, that's telling. Which is extremely bad for Oregon. Extremely bad for Oregon. And unfortunately, with 9 seconds left, they got to get this ball off quick so they can at least get a chance to get a field goal. All right, 2 seconds left. They'll at least get a chance to get a field goal. Down 24-10. I think I've ever seen them down this much. So the EA sim just flashed up the apparent 38-17 Auburn over Georgia, and I would say that's probably a little bit more than Georgia will actually score.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
This is big. First drive of the second half. This is huge. They need to get this thing down, get this thing in the end zone. Close to a 9-yard pickup there. That way they then can turn it over to their defense and hope their defense can create a turnover.
That time, he paid for being a step behind the receiver.
Kaya got taking himself on a quarterback read, and he gets down to the 40-yard line. All right.
Guys, he can throw the ball, he can run it.
We'll see if the U gets shocked here or not.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. He's got it out to his tight end. They'll bring him down at the 48.
No. Earthshakers brought up a Georgia game in which the Georgia player got hit out of bounds. The other player, Georgia player hit it out of his hands, and the Auburn guy caught it. I don't know. Look, the only Georgia Auburn game that I remember is when Uga tried to take a bite out of. Oh God, who was that big? I think it was a big tight end, or it was a big receiver. It was a big dude. Went right for the jewels. That's the only one. It's the only Auburn Georgia game that is definitely in my head. It's just Uga jumping up, trying to take a bite out of Auburn's family jewels. And there's Gus Edwards. They gotta get him going. They definitely gotta get him going if they're gonna win this game. So no, I do not remember the Georgia game that you're talking about.
First down.
I think it was Sanders, actually, up from Auburn. I think that's who it was, who Uga tried to take a bite out of. Nice quarterback read there. Kaya cuts it in. Touchdown, Miami. And the Hurricanes did exactly what they needed to do, getting this thing in, cutting this down to 4.
The uprights with the extra point. looks like they're ready for the kick.
Monday night game is still 7-0, about 5 minutes left to go to the half. Just a nasty slugfest, but the Lions are driving.
Wow, close game here, and up and down the field with both these offenses matching what the others done.
Well, it's fun to watch each offense get an opportunity to go
out. All right, Florida State has their lead cut into a little bit, but they've only been stopped once on a turnover and stopped once on a punt. There's Urban Lane, 11. How many catches did it make? Seven? Six. Six catches, 72 yards, one touchdown so far. He's had a very good day.
They executed that one perfectly.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Florida State is up four. Just throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure.
Second and 10.
That football,
Florida State does not want to. Florida State just wants to continue to respond with touchdowns. Simple as that.
Now he tries to buy some time.
Oh, and Golson breaks two tackles. He's got a lane, and he is slow as anything, but does not matter. Gets it down to the 35-yard line.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35-yard line.
Golson, nice throw there. And that's going to create second and inches.
The 25-yard line.
So Florida State continuing to move that ball. It's got to be depressing for Miami. Miami's defense needs to do something very good. They're just upended on his back. It's turtle time. Got the good old, I'm going to say WWF, because that's what it was when I was growing up. Coming on, bounce the guy off the ropes, shoulder it. Boom, put him down, flat backed.
Makes it out to about the 20.
But then give up. Then the third down, then they convert on third down. So all that is all for naught. Florida State has controlled this game, sort of like Miami did to them down in Tallahassee. So that's
around the 19-yard line.
And it's interesting. But of course, we saw last year, ACC, Florida State, Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech did a good job at controlling that game, but Florida State would come out a win, so we will see. Of course, I'm completely missing that. Florida State is looking for their fourth straight conference championship.
First and goal from the three. They're knocking on the door. Florida State holds a four-point lead. Dives and he's down. That brings up second and goal. This is the 10th play of this drive. Watch out for a pass.
I think I switched the U and the O on that.
Touchdown, Florida State.
Oh, man. Golson takes it in. Back up by 11. 3:40 left to go in the third.
And he tacks on the extra point. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
And we are looking at possibly our first upset of the night.
He sends this one deep. Aguayo has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick.
I say the first upset of the night as if there's going to be a lot more.
Seminole staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around kids like this. They're just fun to be around.
They're fun to be around, and I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really throughout the entire team. It's no wonder this team is so competitive with him at the front.
Kyatt O'Donnell.
Oh, he had some steam on that throw.
Jake O'Donnell, his favorite receiver, but I don't know.
Yards to go. First ball on the 35-yard line.
I don't know if he's going to be able to save them. They need two touchdowns here. They need two touchdowns. Obviously, they need them. They need a hold if they're just going to get two touchdowns. Oh, and there's a good pass out of Berrios, and Berrios gets down inside. Well, gets into Florida State's territory.
the 46-yard line. First down.
Because Edwards cannot get going. They've done a great job wrapping him up. They've only allowed him to have one good run. 12 carries, 46 yards. That's mortal. I mean, normally does not look mortal. That's for sure. Oh, God. Kaya got to get sacked. Third, 15, 2:20 left to go. This is going to be a problem. Kaya looking deep. Oh, and that was almost picked off. He's looking for Berrios on that one. And they're going to have to punt. They're going to have to punt the ball.
Vogel awaits the snap.
And you got to wonder at this point in time.
This punt goes over the goal line.
So far, Florida State has been able to do what they wanted with the ball. So are they going to put it out of reach here for Miami? A touchdown, I got to say, a touchdown put it out of reach.
Green gains around 6 yards on the run. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Golson, nice throw there. Picks up the first down. That's really, I'm afraid this is what we're going to see throughout the final part of this game. Look at that. Golson, 20 for 23. 238 yards, two touchdowns. Very efficient. And this is how you win football games.
The running back gets a yard, maybe less.
And he's brought down there by the senior at linebacker. That won't be the last time today we'll be talking about this young man.
From their own 35-yard line.
Florida State. I can't say anything bad about him right now. Just efficiently moving up the field. Good throw. And that's going to be Jesus Wilson.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback.
4 catches, 64 yards on the day. Got Ermin Lane with 7 catches, 74 yards. Doing a great job hooking up with his wide receivers. His best wide receivers there. Probably. And we're going to kick it down to the third, Rudolph. And I think it's only a second reception. Oh, four receptions on 42 yards. Golson just... If Golson had played like this throughout the season, Florida State would be undefeated. It would be it'd be the other way around. Florida State would be number two looking to go to the college football playoffs. But he didn't. He was horrible. He wasn't that great against Florida last couple weeks ago down in the swamp. They lost that one.
That's three down and one to go.
He wasn't very good in Atlanta. They lost that one. Georgia Tech wasn't very good. He was okay. He didn't turn over the ball. I guess that's the whole point. He didn't turn over the ball, but he wasn't like this. He wasn't this efficient. There it is off to Lane. Lane's going to pick up the first down. Miami cannot keep them off the field.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down. And a nice catch there.
Good tippy-toe catch.
Play the drive. Here's the halfback. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a gain of 4. That makes it 2nd and 6.
So Miami, after doing just a beautiful job throughout Fat Finger broadcasts, going undefeated. They've been on here 4 times, I believe. The first one was the game in Tallahassee, which they won 34-17. The next week, they took on Virginia Tech. Held off Virginia Tech at the end for a 2014 win. Then you had the Clemson game, in which they pretty much took Clemson. I think it was 44-23. That was on Fat Finger Gaming. And then, of course, the absolute thriller that came down to the last second field goal in which Miami would convert on a 4th-and-8. Yeah, under a minute left to go in the game to get themselves into field goal range for the field goal that kept them undefeated 16-14 against UNC in Chapel Hill. And then they crushed Georgia Tech. So if they were 5-0 on Fat Finger Gaming. They looked good, but they have not looked good.
They've stepped up today. They just seem to be dialed into what this offense is trying to do. Good job against the run. They've been very physical. What I love is how relentless they run to the football.
He's on the run. And they finally knock him out at the 47-yard line. First down.
I'm trying to go quick, go fast.
Edwards takes a pitch. Nice run there as they work the outside.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it 2nd-and-4.
About the 29-yard line. From the 29-yard line. First down.
Guy almost to 300 mark. He's definitely going to have to get over it if they're going to try to win this one. Miami not out of it, but man. Holding Florida State to field goal was huge. Kaya going to run it, going to slide, going to force 2nd-and-2, which is good. Just keep that ball moving. Keep the ball moving towards that end zone and get in that end zone. That's going to be a first down. Little smoke route there to Waters.
From the 19-yard line, first down.
Gus Edwards trying to get moving. Florida State has, without a doubt, made a pact. To just take care of Edwards.
This is the 8th play of this drive. Look at him scramble down. He can't get away from the pressure.
I mean, 4th-and-14 in this eye. They're already saying this is it. Kaya barking out the Seagulls. 4th-and-14. A lot. It's going to be. Oh, and they're going to end with a sack.
They're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on 4th-and-long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
Both teams are well aware that a score.
And that's it. 3:39. Looks like we will be giving Florida State their 4th straight ACC championship. Everett Golson, I mean, before that, he was 26 for 20. It's just one of those a little too late, maybe, guys. I realize the defense looking good here.
Quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, 5 wide receivers in the formation.
Oklahoma. third and 12, and they're going to force a punt. But, you know, it's 2:40 left to go in this game. They're down by two touchdowns. I hate to say it's over,
and watch out. They're going to bring the heat right here.
So our next championship game will be the SEC championship game. Auburn, Georgia. SEC West looking to make it seven straight championship games. I can't argue with the fact that it ain't going to happen. Or it is going to happen. Sorry, it is going to happen. Georgia's offense is completely inept. Auburn's defense is the best in the nation. And ever since about week four or five, they've actually started slowly putting the pieces together on offense, and they are running at full stride now. The 49-28 victory over Alabama in the Iron Bowl. Without a doubt, shows just how great Auburn has been playing on offense. Before their wins, they were having to rely on their defense setting them up. Embarrassingly for Auburn was the LSU game, in which they lost to LSU. Their defense had five turnovers, turning one, and all five turnovers put Auburn somewhere in good field position, whether it was straight scoring position, one even was returned for a touchdown. But yet they only managed 24 points and they lost 35-24. I mean, if you turn the ball, now they did turn over the ball twice, but still, if you turn the ball over five times and you lose, someone's getting fired. And I did think, when they went up against Mississippi State, I seriously thought of putting White in, but decided I'd give him one more game. And Jeremy Johnson looked good enough. And that's actually the game in which he started to get better and get better and get better. Which, funny enough, you go into reality, and they didn't give Jeremy Johnson that game at all to get himself back together, put in White, and of course they lose 17-9 to Mississippi State. So maybe I don't think that change was necessary. I don't think White brought anything to the table that was anything better. I would rather just try to see if my starting quarterback can shake off the cobwebs and get going. Unless you knew that his confidence was rattled, unless you knew without a doubt that his confidence was done, then it'd be a good move. It would have been a good move.
Quick throw, and he hits him hard at the 1 yard line.
So it looks like Miami will get in a little touchdown here. Kai, 368 yards. Most of that is just desperation yards. And that is a touchdown to Cooley. That's his second touchdown of the day. First touchdown, of course, being the bomb that we thought that's how Miami just starts rolling. But it was not. Miami cannot roll. Florida State continues to control this game from the very first drive till the end. Miami cannot get a lead the entire game. And Florida State will be crowned ACC champions.
He's tackled at the 45-yard line.
Illegal touching. Offense. Still first down.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. And this should be a kneel down as they just tried.
And here we go.
Takes a knee. The Hurricanes using
four straight. four straight ACC championship.
Is up a score. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee.
Wow. Completely disappointing, folks.
And so that's going to do it. The Seminoles come out on top, 34-27.
Completely disappointing.
Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us? You
wouldn't think big time upset here. And it'd go right down to the very end. I definitely had Miami in this game. I had Miami with the points. I had Miami giving up the points even. That's how bad this was. Evenly matched teams. Whoever comes through in the clutch. Yikes. Oh man. Today's win puts them there it is. Hoisted up the ACC championship. And for the Hurricanes. Have I said four straight? That's what kicks me in the season. All right, there we go. Let's get the stats up. Our SEC championship will start in a little while. We're going to show the stats here. Platinum Dog. Thank you for your follow. I appreciate the follows. I appreciate activity in the Twitch. If you like talking about whatever the hell you want to talk about, ish. We normally talk about college football and or our own dynasties, our own roads to glory, whatever. But we do go off topic a lot and talk about whatever. You are my 50th. I got the NFL 50. Followers now, look at that. Golson, 28 for 38, 293, two touchdowns. Telling you, the kid played like that in all the games, they would have been just fine. They couldn't get anything going on the ground. It did not matter. Lane, seven catches. He's done a great job for Florida State this year. Oh, man. Sacks, seven sacks on the day for the crew. Oops. Then over on the absolutely depressed side, undefeated, and they go down in the conference championship. It's going to be interesting how the ACC does in bowl season, where all people go with the bowls. Man, depressing. No, not no.